Hi, I'm Robert Osborne. Thanks so much for joining us. Our next musical biography on this Independence Day focuses on American composer John Philip Sousa, who gave us all sorts of rousing musical marches, even though you might not recognize them by name, although one of them, Stars and Stripes Forever, also happens to be the title of this next movie. It's from 20th Century Fox in 1952. It's in bright and sunny Technicolor, and it tells Sousa's story from his time as the leader of the Marine Corps band in the 1800s, to the formation of his own band in 1892, a band which later performed all over the world and made his name world famous. The film is loosely based on Sousa's autobiography, which he called Marching Along, and in this movie it's not only his marches you'll be hearing. Sousa, despite being known as the March King, also composed many ballads, and you'll be hearing some of them as well in the film. And an interesting point the movie makes is that Sousa would rather have been known for those ballads that he wrote than for his marches, which won him such worldwide acclaim. Starring in the film as John Philip Sousa is Clifton Webb, who at that time was guaranteed money in the bank for any movie he was in. He was one of the most unlikely stars imaginable in Hollywood at that time. He was already well into his 50s when moviegoers first got to know him in supporting roles in films such as the murder mystery Laura and the drama The Razor's Edge. Then he had starred as a know-it-all babysitter named Mr. Belvedere in the 1948 comedy Sitting Pretty, which became a humongous hit and earned Webb an Academy Award nomination as Best Actor. And suddenly he was a star, and audiences couldn't get enough of him. So here he was at age 60, a most unlikely star, in an industry always celebrating youth. But it was his popularity which helped turn this next film into a moneymaker. Joining him in the cast is a 21-year-old Robert Wagner, also Deborah Padgett as Bob's love interest, and Ruth Hussey as Sousa's wife. So from 1952, Stars and Stripes Forever. Clifton Webb, who played John Philip Sousa, was given a choice. He could play John Philip Sousa in this film at his home studio of 20th Century Fox, or he could go on loan out to MGM Studios and co-star with Fred Astaire and director Vincent Minnelli's big musical, The Bandwagon. And Webb chose to play Sousa. But what a pity he couldn't do both. Webb was a great dancer, you know, on a par with Fred Astaire. And like Astaire, Webb was a big star in Broadway musicals and revues in the 20s and 30s. What a treat it would be to have filmed today with both those elegant, debonair gentlemen dancing together. Now, as part of the publicity surrounding our movie's release, the U.S. Marine Band, with presidential approval, played at this film's New York premiere at the Roxy Theater, marking the first time the band had ever played at any such event.